We are going to look at how to make measurements using centimeters and millimeters. First thing you need to know is how to recognize your units on a ruler. So on our ruler at the top here, the numbers that are right side up, those are the inches. And in this case, the numbers that are upside down are your metric units. Now, notice that it says millimeters right here. That is telling you your smallest division. The numbers that are actually labeled are centimeters. So that's a little deceiving. So, by following the actual numbers on here, those are your centimeters. And if you're looking at your ruler and can't decide which side is inches and which side is metric, you're going to have a lot more numbers on your metric side. So whichever side goes up to bigger numbers, that is the centimeter or metric side. So your numbers are centimeters. Your smaller divisions are millimeters, and you're going to have 10 millimeters for every 1 centimeter, which means that converting between millimeters and centimeters is just going to be a matter of moving a decimal point one place, which is infinitely easier than dealing with inches and fractions of an inch and feet and so on. So below we have a ruler that is labeled in centimeters, and you can tell because there are 10 divisions for each number. And we have a pencil here. Now note, this pencil is actually quite small and I shrunk the image so that it would fit next to this relatively small portion of a centimeter ruler. So, in our system here, if we look at, I tried to line up the base of the pencil with the zero, and here's the tip of our pencil. So in centimeters, we see that it is greater than 3 centimeters and less than 4. And we can count divisions to actually write it as a decimal. And in this case, there's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 lines. So that means that that pencil is 3.7 centimeters. Now remember, each little line is a millimeter. So you could, if you were very anal retentive, count every single one of those little lines, or you could remember that every 1 centimeter is 10 millimeters, so 10, 20, 30 millimeters plus that 7 extra lines means that that is 37 millimeters. So whenever you are in a situation where you are making measurements using the metric system, remember that your numbers that are given are centimeters, and the small divisions are millimeters. As long as you remember that, you can't go wrong making measurements using the metric system.